Each month, more Unreal Engine 5 games are being released, and the most recent one is RoboCop Rogue City. This is a new first-person shooter developed by Cheon, and much like most recent Unreal Engine 5 titles, this game and most parts showcases impressive visuals, thanks to UE5's feature set. However, on the other hand, there are some technical issues, and the performance is not optimal, especially at the highest settings and resolution. That's why today in this video, we'll discuss the technical problems, and as usual, we'll go through the game's graphic settings and examine the performance and visual impacts of each one. And we'll also try to squeeze more performance and improve the game's visuals using some Unreal Engine 5 parameters and console commands. So without any further ado, let's get started. Now, as I mentioned during the intro, the game's visuals are truly impressive, with Lumen in particular playing a significant role in achieving this stunning appearance. But it's worth noting that the game only utilized software Lumen, which is less accurate than hardware Lumen and can sometimes fail to accurately capture all objects in the scene. This limitation also extends to reflections, which despite their ray tracing nature, rely more on screen space data to add in details, characters, and object shading. And of course, as an Unreal Engine game, RoboCop Rogue City suffers from traversal stuttering, but fortunately, it's not as frequent as other UE5 games. And when it comes to upscaling, RoboCop supports all available upscaling techniques. Here we have DLSS, FSR2, DP4A XeSS, in addition to Unreal Engine 5's TSR. And for native rendering, we have TAA, TSR, and DLAA. And in terms of quality, each one has some issues. For starters, FSR2 and XeSS suffer from shimmering and look less stable compared to DLSS and TSR. And every upscaling technique other than TSR showcases low resolution particles when using low or medium post-processing, as you can see here. And even at native resolution, DLAA has the same problem. However, pushing post-processing to high or epic fixes this issue and improves the resolution of particles. And DLSS in this game suffers from a visual bug and exhibits light flickering. And I found that using high post-processing can fix this issue. And disabling this setting called high quality lumen reflection can also get rid of this problem. Now, RoboCop Rogue City doesn't offer a lot of settings to tweak, and what's even worse is that some settings affect many visual aspects at the same time. For example, let's examine the shadow setting. This one controls the resolution and quality of shadows as expected, but it also affects the volumetric lighting in the game, which makes low, as you can see here, looks dark compared to the other options. And performance-wise at this scene, going from low to medium costs around 10%, to high 16% and to epic 18%. However, on most other scenes like here, the difference between low and medium is much smaller. So for this one, I recommend medium or high shadows. Next, we have view distance. This one controls the draw distance of some elements, including visual effects, as you can see here. In addition to ground details, where low shows noticeable pop-in compared to epic. And here I couldn't measure any performance difference between the two options. Therefore, I recommend keeping this one at epic. Anti-aliasing adjusts the quality of the game's TAA and TSR. Like here, you can see how going from low to epic reduces the visibility of shimmering and aliasing, with negligible performance impact. So if you are using TAA or TSR, I recommend keeping this one at epic. Post-processing adjusts the quality of some post-processing effects like depth of field, as you can see here, where low disables depth of field and going from medium and above improves the quality of this effect. And as I mentioned earlier, medium post-processing can affect the visual side of particles when using anything other than TSR or TAA. But for other VFX like this scene here, post-processing have a big impact on the performance side, where going from low and medium to high and epic costs around 16%. So here I highly recommend keeping post-processing at low or medium. And when it comes to textures, much like other recent UE5 games, RoboCop takes advantage of Unreal Engine 5's virtual texturing, which delivers high-quality textures with reasonable VRAM usage. However, this method is still not perfect, because similar to many other UE5 games, RoboCop has noticeable texture pop-in close to the camera, where most textures take a lot of time to load, as you can see here. And when it comes to texture stitching, there is no visual difference between low and epic, and even the allocated and used VRAM are almost identical. Let's move on to effects. This one adjusts the visibility of some visual effects, like fire, as you can see here. However, most importantly, the stitching affects the quality of both Lumen Global Illumination, as you can see here, and Lumen Reflections, where both low and medium shows a lot of noise compared to high and epic. And performance-wise, the results vary depending on the scene. For example, here at this one, with fire and other visual effects, going from low to medium costs around 4%, to high 7%, and to epic 13%. And here at this scene, there is no noticeable difference when going from low to high. However, going to epic costs around 14%. And finally, we have this scene with reflections, where going from low and medium to high costs around 12%, and to epic 18%. So here, given that both low and medium significantly compromise the appearance of reflections, I recommend high effects. And lastly, we have high quality Lumen Reflection. This stitching mainly adds reflections to some transparent surfaces, like here where we can see that this window of this store shows a low quality reflection of the scene behind the camera. And performance wise, enabling this stitching can cost around 7%. So here I recommend keeping this one disabled, because it's hard to notice the visual impact of this stitching, and as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, enabling it can cause light flickering when using DLSS. Now let's delve deeper and access some settings that the game's graphics menu doesn't include. We'll be using a file called engine.ini, which allows us to edit the default value for Unreal Engine console commands. To access this file, first make sure to run the game at least once. After that, press the Windows key and R on your keyboard, and type the following command in the run window. Then go to RoboCop, Saved, Config, Windows, and look for engine.ini, and open it with any text editor. And here, make sure to add this line, System Settings, and under it, we'll add more commands. The first one is our reflection method, which when set to true, replaces Lumen Reflections with Screen Space Reflections, as you can see here. This leads to a significant performance gain. The largest I've seen is here with around 44%. You can also add this command, R depth of field quality, which when set to 0, disables depth of field completely, regardless of the post-processing setting. Additionally, there are two more commands that should improve the game's visuals with no performance penalty. The first is R Lumen Reflections Temporal, which when set to 0, disables the temporal filter used in Lumen Reflections, leading to cleaner reflections, particularly with DLSS, as you can see here. The second command is R Lumen Screens Probe Gather Temporal Max Frames Accumulated, and setting this one to 32 decreases the noise in Lumen Global Illumination, as you can see here. And I'll include all the commands we used alongside additional ones in the description down below. And based on everything we've seen so far, these are my recommended settings. Now let's compare optimized settings, including the engine tweaks, with Epic preset at 1440p using DLSS quality mode. And the performance difference between Epic preset and optimized settings can vary depending on the scene. Like here, we can see around 33% performance gain. But in another scene like here, we can see around 41% difference between Epic preset and optimized settings. And with that, we reach the conclusion of this video. Thank you so much for watching and for your time. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like. If not, feel free to leave a dislike. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for future videos. And hopefully, I'll see you all in the next one.